In this example, we will examine the motion of an object that is moving in a circular path and is subjected to multiple forces. A small sphere of mass m is suspended by two wires that are both oriented at an angle theta equal to 30 degrees relative to the horizontal. If wire 1 is suddenly cut, what is the ratio of the tension in wire 2 immediately after wire 1 is cut to the initial tension in wire 2? For this problem, we will assume that the size of the sphere is much smaller than the radius of curvature of its path, allowing us to treat the sphere as a particle. First, draw a free body diagram of the sphere before wire 1 is cut, and identify the coordinate system. Since the sphere is not moving, a rectangular coordinate system is more convenient. The weight points downward and has a magnitude of m times g, the gravitational acceleration constant. The tension in wire 1 has a magnitude of T1, and the tension in wire 2 has a magnitude of T2. Both tensions are oriented an angle theta from the horizontal. Next, we apply the equations of motion. The sum of the external forces in the x direction is equal to the sphere's mass times the acceleration in the x direction. And the sum of the external forces in the y direction is equal to the sphere's mass times the acceleration in the y direction. The acceleration is zero in both directions since the sphere is at rest when it is suspended by the two wires. The sum of the external forces in the x direction is the component of T2 in the x direction, which is T2 times cosine theta, minus the component of T1 in the x direction, which is T1 times cosine theta. Before the cut, the tension in both wires is the same. All three forces have components in the y direction. The tensions point upward while the weight points downward. The sum of the forces in the y direction is T2 times sine theta plus T1 times sine theta minus mg. Plugging in equation 1 into equation 2 and solving for T2, we obtain an expression for T2 in terms of m, g, and theta. After wire 1 is cut, the tension in wire 2 is T2 prime. Since the sphere will start to move in a circular path, normal and tangential coordinates will be more convenient. The t-coordinate points in the direction tangent to the sphere's circular path, and the n-coordinate points toward the center of curvature. The weight still points downward with a magnitude mg, and is oriented an angle theta from the t-direction. Applying the equations of motion, the sum of the external forces in the t-direction is equal to the sphere's mass times the acceleration in the t-direction, and the sum of the external forces in the n-direction is equal to the sphere's mass times the acceleration in the n-direction. In the t-direction, the weight has a component that points in the positive direction with a magnitude mg times cosine theta. The acceleration in the t-direction is equal to the time rate of change of the sphere's speed, v dot. It turns out that this equation is not useful in solving this problem. In the n-direction, the sum of the forces is T2 prime minus the n component of the weight, which is mg times sine theta. The normal acceleration is the velocity of the sphere squared divided by the radius of curvature of the sphere's path, rho. V is zero since the sphere starts from rest. We now have an expression for T2 prime in terms of m, g, and theta, and can find the ratio of the tension in wire 2 immediately after wire 1 is cut to the initial tension in wire 2. After canceling terms and plugging in the value for theta, the answer is 1/2.